Hi, I'm Emily and I'm here with Maya Murphy's attorney, Lauren McDonald. Attorney McDonald practices at Maya Murphy's Westport, Connecticut office and is admitted to practice law in both Connecticut and New York. My question today for attorney McDonald is, what if my child is placed in private school or referred to a private school? Am I eligible for reimbursement if my child attends a private school?
Hi, Emily. Thank you for those great questions. Due to the cost of enrolling a child in private school, major issues surrounding reimbursement for such placement arise between parents and school districts. The school district is obligated to provide your child with a free, appropriate education, otherwise known as FAPE, which embraces the possibility that enrollment in a private school may be necessary to meet your child's needs. If your school district determines that your child's special education requirements would be met in a private school, they may make the appropriate referral. Prior to referring your child for private school placement, the local education agency, otherwise known as LEA, must develop an IEP for your child. The public school must ensure that a representative of the private school attends this meeting, and if they're unable to attend, your child's public school must use other methods to ensure their participation, such as an individual or conference telephone calls. The school board must concur with the initial finding that placement in a private institution is necessary and proper, and that no state institution is available to meet your child's needs. The school district must pay the reasonable costs of your child's enrollment in the private school. However, the LEA, the local education agency, is not required to pay for the cost of your child's education, including special education and related services, if a free, appropriate education has otherwise been made available to your child, and as a parent, you have elected to place your child in a private school. Most issues pertaining to elective private school placement arise between parents and the school district regarding the availability of an appropriate education and the question of financial reimbursement. Disagreements on these matters are subject to the due process procedures. As a parent of a child with a disability, you have the right to enroll your child in private school as you see fit. However, your public school district concludes that they're able to provide an appropriate education for your child, a dispute over reimbursement is likely to arise. Enrollment of your child in private school without the local education agency's consent or referral may lead to a dispute as to the need for this enrollment in order to provide an appropriate education for your child. If a due process hearing officer finds that the agency has not made a free, appropriate education available for your child and private school placement was appropriate, you will be entitled to full reimbursement for the cost of enrolling your child in a private school. Although a hearing officer, after a hearing, may find that you're entitled to full reimbursement by your school district for the cost of private school placement, reimbursement still may be reduced or denied due to the following circumstances. First, if you fail to inform your child's public school at the last PPT or IEPT meeting you attended prior to removing your child that you were rejecting the placement proposal by the public school agency to provide a free appropriate education to your child. You must have stated your concerns and intent to enroll your child in private school at public expense. This information must be provided in writing by a parent at least 10 business days prior to the removal of your child from his or her public school. Second, if prior to the removal of your child from public school, the local education agency had informed you of its intent to evaluate your child and you failed to make your child available for an evaluation. Or three, if there's a judicial finding of parental unreasonableness in enrolling your child in private school without the public school's acquiescence. Adhering to these three requirements will allow the public school district an opportunity to address your concerns and make any necessary changes to your child's program prior to you removing your child and placing them in private school. Under certain circumstances, the school district will not be entitled to a reduction or full abatement of reimbursement for the cost of enrolling your child in private school if you can show, one, that the school prevented you from providing them with notice of your decision to remove your child, or two, Compliance with the notice requirement would likely have resulted in physical or emotional harm to your child. Or three, if you're unable to read and write in English, reimbursement will not be reduced or declined for failure to adhere to the notice requirements. If you have any questions about private school placement or reimbursement from a public school district, please feel free to give me a call.